Hi folks, my lucky 13 harmonica, the unique 13 hole diatonic with the extended bass range, has been selling around the world now for about 4 years, and in that time we've had some great feedback from the players who bought it. Incorporating some of their suggestions plus some ideas of my own, I've worked with the manufacturer's Eastop to create an all new improved Mk2 lucky 13. It's got some great new features inside, so let me explain what they are. First of all, the cover plates. We've replaced the matte black cover plates of the original model with these new dark, glossy, lacquered cover plates, and these are super smooth in your mouth. These dark cover plates go on the more bluesy models, like the standard Richter Lucky 13, Power Bender, and Power Draw. On the more melody-based Lucky 13s, like Solo Tuning, Power Chromatic, and Paddy Richter, we've got chromed brass cover plates. The Lucky 13 is a big harp in every way. It's got a big sound, but it's also bigger physically, with a longer length. And that extra length can make it difficult to find your way around. For my own Lucky 13s, I started creating special 3D printed combs with what I call look dots on the front. These are little dots, position markers, that help me see exactly where I was in the harp. And I like the look dots so much for my own Lucky 13s that I decided to put them on the factory model as well. There's two patterns of look dots. There's two look dots on the front for the more kind of Richter-based bluesier harps like Standard Richter, Power Bender, Power Draw, and Paddy Richter. On the two Lucky 13s where the octaves repeat every four holes, we've got three look dots. You'll be amazed at what a difference these little look dots make. Now, with a quick glance down at your harp, you can go straight to the hole you're after. Now, some players felt on the original Lucky 13 that the low octave was a bit quieter than the normal low octave. And that's because the big low reeds are swinging more and letting more air through. So in order to balance up the sound a bit, we've included selective valving in the lowest octave of the Lucky 13. There's three valves on the inside to bring out the lower blow notes, and there's two valves on the outside to bring out the sound of the lowest two draw notes. So now the low octave sounds similar in volume to the normal low octave. And that goes for the volume of the single notes as well. I think most of you will appreciate the effect of the low-end valves in the Lucky 13 Mk2. But if you're not mad about them, it's very easy to fix. Just get in there and pull them off. Then the Lucky 13 will sound just the same in the bottom end as your old Lucky 13 did. Well, to commemorate the release of the Lucky 13 Mk2, we've created an all-new box for it. As you can see, it's bigger, it's more colourful, and there's more info on it. There's info in several different languages there, plus a list of all the six different kinds of Lucky 13 you can buy. The new box also comes with a detailed info sheet. It's got tuning diagrams for all of the six kinds of Lucky 13 and a little bit extra info on what they're all about. Well, the bigger box means we can now fit three Lucky 13s inside. You can either buy the Lucky 13 as a single harp, or you can buy it in batches of 3, or 6, or 12. And you can mix and match between different types of Lucky 13, different tunings, different keys, whatever you like. And there's price discounts for the 3, 6, and 12 option Lucky 13s. There's a link on the back of the box where you can go for more information on the Lucky 13, and also to look into spare parts, accessories, and all that kind of thing. Over the next few months, I'll be doing special videos on all the six different kinds of Lucky 13 you can buy. I'll also be doing short instructional videos showing all the cool new things you can do with that extra bottom end range of the Lucky 13. Bye for now. Oh,